One of the most unique and strangely enjoyable role-playing experiences I had was while beta testing a homebrewed fantasy RPG for my DM. But what made the evening strange, unique, and enjoyable wasn't the game system, but was in fact the players that evening. You see, this night I'd be playing with someone who had been kicked out of the gaming group before I ever became part of it. He also used to date my ex-girlfriend. She's the person who got me into this gaming group in the first place, and he was the one who brought her into the group, and then he got kicked out when they broke up, and then she brought me into the group, and then she stopped playing after we broke up. I suspect this sort of Brady Bunch shuffle happens in a lot of gaming groups involving couples. So in any event, I was gearing up for a very special evening with my ex-girlfriend's ex-boyfriend, from here on out referred to as Double X. He shows up with two of his roommates, and actually everything's normal. We eat snacks and talk nerd crap for a while. He seems like he's going to be a perfectly delightful co-role player for the evening. Then we begin to play. Our party found itself snowed into a mountain village on the one night of the year when an eldritch monstrosity is scheduled to clean its boots on the collected souls of the townsfolk. Normally they'd vacate the area when this occurred, but an especially bad winter had made all the passes inaccessible, and even if they were clear, any kind of long trip would be a gamble in such weather. We spent a fair part of that morning failing to locate a way out of the town. It looked like we were going to be part of the upcoming conflict, and we were definitely going to be on the underdog team. With nothing to do but find a place to hole up and begin fortifications, we went to the inn and started boarding up windows. Well, most of us. Double X goes behind the bar and starts making Molotov cocktails. Now, on one level, I can certainly understand the impulse. We were basically playing Call of Cthulhu, but with no firearms and no magic. And wanting to face an elder god with something besides a piece of sharpened steel is perfectly understandable. On the other hand, I doubt Glartleflarp the Unjust had crossed the abyss of time and space just to be stopped by a bottle of Rumpelmitschnapps and a Miss Bic Flex. So while he's stuffing rags into bottles of booze, his roommate suggests that while Molotov cocktails are great for burning down buildings, they aren't so good at not burning down buildings, and the building we were currently occupying might be the only thing keeping Cthulhu from vigorously inserting us into his beefanged anus. It was pretty clear to the group that we were going to be in a Night of the Living Dead type scenario, you know, holed up, trying to survive the night. And true to that film, an argument broke out about using the firebombs inside the wooden structure that almost destroyed the party. Double X ignores his roommate and ends up using all the hooch in the bar to make firebombs, and then he decides to take a nap since we'd probably be fighting throughout the night. While he's doing that, his roommate steals his firebombs and hides them. While this is happening, Double X is getting furious, and as soon as his character wakes up, he sits up and says,
"Where are my Molotov cocktails?"
As if his character had just woken from a horrible nightmare where he didn't get to accidentally burn his friends to death. Double X knows what happened to his firebombs, and his character has a pretty good idea too, so this leads to another argument, and Double X begins tearing up the inn, looking for his IEDs, and eventually he finds them. Around this time, the Elder Horror began controlling one of the NPCs in the inn, and the NPC began hovering in the air and attacking us like a deadite from the Evil Dead series, using supernatural strength and speed to beat on us. Apparently, the Dark Horror had snuck in a tendril under the front door and up this guy's pant leg and was now working the guy like a puppet. The exact methods he used to enter this poor NPC is probably best left unsaid. So Double X finally decides to throw one of his firebombs at the possessed NPC, and of course, he fumbles the roll. The DM rolls for scatter, and he lights up his roommate, who spent the last hour trying to stop this very thing from happening. So now the fight splits off in two directions. There's me, trying to stop Grimgadoosh of the Thousand Young from eating our faces, and then there's these two knuckleheads hacking pieces out of each other, and I mean that literally. Imagine if every blow landed made your character crappier, because in this game, with its very gritty battle system, every blow that lands hits a specific location. If it lands on a limb, that limb is crippled, and without any magic healing available, that means you're pretty much crap for the rest of the session. So, no matter who won this fight, we were going to be down two party members. And even though things were getting kind of tense at the table in general, I was managing to have a pretty great time. You see, I already got to play this scenario once before with our regular gaming group, and watching two roommates in their 30s express years of cohabitation gripes through fantasy combat was way more interesting than just revisiting a railroady survival horror scenario I had played only a few weeks earlier. Sure, there was an Eldritch Horror to fight, but he doesn't keep using my coffee creamer and never replacing it, does he, Barry? And because I had played the scenario once before, I knew how to make an effective character for it. And with the help of some good dice rolls, I actually managed to chop the possessed NPC into pieces before he could do too much damage. But absolutely nobody cared, because there was an inter-party combat going on, and that sucked all the air out of the room. Eventually, Double X won the fight, using the fact that he wasn't on fire to his advantage. In my experience, when one player kills another player at the game table. That's usually the end of the game session. And this session was no different. The player of the dead character maintained a good humor about it, but when the DM offered to let him play as one of the townsfolk in the inn, he declined. It was getting awkward and late, and we decided to call it a night. I know this sounds like the story of a total disaster at the game table, and it was certainly for the DM. I mean, he wanted to test out his game system, not watch an inter-party meltdown. But I really had a blast. I spent most of the night laughing into my hand. By the end of the evening, my cheeks hurt. I'm not a total tool. I feel bad about it. But all of that aside, this was the only time I ever felt like a NASCAR fan witnessing a spectacular crash after a mind-numbing season of watching cars drive in a circle.